Hello, Malty Mature Minchies. And thank you to Sam Ham for that malt mention. Introducing Ralfy Review 874 Extras. Extra content about extra whiskies and extra perspective. Because one of the best ways to improve our experience of good quality liquors is to listen to other people's experience, cross-reference, recalibrate, and no more. No more than the day before. We've all got to start somewhere, and for some people it can be a very slow apprenticeship, and for other people it can be quite rapid. People can have the budget and the range of experience to pick up a lot about whiskies and other quality spirits in just a couple of years. And for other people it can take a lot longer. Don't worry, and this just to reassure you malt mates, don't you worry a jot about how slow or quick you are to pick up the smell and taste of whiskey. It's not some, there's no destination, there's no golden prize. It's the journey that matters, not the final result. And inevitably, it doesn't matter what your senses are like. You're going to learn so much more over time if you sustain that reasonable, focused interest, manage your budgets, watch the volume that you drink, be careful about that, and just enjoy the experience. And some malt mates are very conventional about it. They're quite orthodox. You know, whatever the distiller produces is sacrosanct, whether it be blends or single malts, and it's nothing to be interfered with. Whereas for others, it's open season, experiment, play around with it, because it's amazing what you learn. Anyway, bigclivedot.com, link to the video down below in the description box, is my little brother, and he has produced a clickbait whisky themed video to take the piss out of me. And I have to say, I'm deeply honoured and quite flattered, because it could be a lot worse. He could have been on his videos paying me compliments. Now, that would make me poop my pants more than anything else. So he took a bottle of whiskey, which he bought at the supermarket, as cheap as he could buy it, called Crag and Glen. What a great name for a Scotch blended whiskey. And you've got the Glen and you've got the Crags, and it's all Scottishy up, and it's not too expensive. Aged 3 years, hey, good in the supermarkets for using age statements. Thank you, supermarkets, for your integrity and your honesty with us. We appreciate it, because it's your way of showing that our business is valued to you. And you're not going to withhold information and withhold disclosure. Thanks, supermarkets. Some distillery bottlings, official bottlings, could learn a lot from you. So Clive puts on this ridiculous red, ugly, stripy cap. Far less classy than mine, because mine's a proper tweed bonnet. But he puts on this shitty little eBay bonnet that cost him £5 or something. And he takes his bottle of whiskey and he puts it into his electric water purifier, which is a simple little device that purifies water, takes out the impurities. And he decides to take the impurities out the whiskey. And I recommend you go and see the video to see what's lying at the bottom of his purifier, the impurities. So I'm going to review the results from a whiskey connoisseur's perspective. I don't care about the I'm going to call myself a connoisseur. I am a connoisseur. I am. I'm not listening to the haters. Then when he had purified the whiskey, I have a glass here of Crag and Glen, he then poured a bottle of supermarket vodka into the purifier, into the brown residue, syrupy stuff, sludge at the bottom, to get the flavour back out again. Now, I don't know of anybody that's ever done this before. What's the point? apart from a gimmick, what is there to learn from it? Well, I'll share my tasting notes and then you decide. It is through the unconventional experimentation with just ordinary home utensils and equipment that we can find a different perspective on the spirits that we pay good money for. We can understand them better by simply seeing them and experiencing them and tasting them and smelling them from a different angle. And that's what I'm doing here. Here is the whisky, which has been purified. Some distilleries in the world do this on a more conventional, way using actual stills. They take cheap, inferior spirit and they redistill it and rebadge it as superior spirit. And all they did was boil up the pot. It happens. Soft, creamy, sweet. There's a corn note to it. It's like a corn whiskey, which is something aromatic, slightly aromatic, confectionery put in it. And there's a little bit of barley grain softness, like a barley grain vodka. The smell is sort of indistinct. It's generalized and confectionery, like what you would call pastels, cream pastels with rose flavor or orange flavor or lemon flavor, all mixed together. This tastes like a deliciously soft, sweet, simple, 3-year-old blended Scotch whisky. There's still flavour in it. Quite a lot of flavour. Soft flavour. The harshness, the tannins, the nip and the sting of caramel has been removed. And you're getting what is far from being a neutral spirit. It just isn't, because a water purifier is simply not calibrated that way. It's quite a simple operation. And the results are, and I'm going to add a bit of water to this to try and get a little bit more access, are surprisingly not shocking. You add a drop of water and there's more grain, little note of barley sugar coming out, and a little bit of dry woodiness. Immediately the palate expands significantly. We now have a definitive separation between the arrival and the development. The finish is the most neutral part of the experience. There's not a lot in the finish, some mild lemon oil and a little bit of icing sugar in the finish, but that's about it. Has the whole process improved the whisky or made it worse? Well, frankly, neither, because I've tasted this before. It was put into a water purifier. It just tastes different, distinctly different. I've had worse single malts. And it's cheap as chips to do this. But how about the vodka? How about the whiskey residue which was left behind in the water distillation pot, then getting mixed in with some bog standard supermarket vodka? Well, for starters, you can clearly see that colour, and that colour is E150A, most of it. When you nose it, it's almost, there's a distinct vodka note with a mere hint of oakiness. woodiness. It's more wood than oak. So I'm going to straight into the taste. There are people who could be served that in a bar and would swear blind it was a blended whiskey. People who don't know whiskey would seriously struggle to identify that as vodka. I'm going to add a drop of water. It has a slight icing sugar note, tannic note coming from the, and bitter note, which the vodka being, we don't need any more water than that, which the vodka being relatively neutral and slightly creamy has really kind of balanced off the harsh leftovers of the Scotch whisky, which remained as a sort of bitter syrup. And it's just completely reabsorbed due to the solvent effect of in the vodka and the ethanol in the vodka. And adding water just actually starts to reclaim some whisky notes in this vodka to a far better standard than I anticipated. It's a novelty, it's surprising, it's a little bit head scratching. I would never dream of doing this. I think it's far too flippant. I think it's far too clickbaity. But my brother has no qualms about it because he does like the opportunity now and again to take the piss out of me. And fair play. What bugs me more than anything is he's got over 300,000 hits on his video relating to this with his big clickbaity, you know, banner thing that he has. What are they called again? Thumbnails, is thumbnail image. So an awful lot more people want to watch a whiskey being trashed through a water purifier than they do listening to me wax lyrical about some seriously good single malts. So a little bit concerning in that respect, malt mates and Clivey fans, because I know you're watching too. But my final verdict is the simple. Now it's tasting more like vodka. Adding water, the vodka is re-exerting itself, that specific vodka flavour. Whereas with the whiskey, most certainly the better experience, the superior result, which has really emphasised the more delicate nature of barley and mixed mash bill, Scotch blended whiskey, even at 3 years old. What's happened actually is the whole process of going through a water purifier has receded this 3 year old whiskey back to its new make status and profile coming out the stills. I'm Ralphie. Oh, we've enjoyed this little alternative malt moment. Well, blended Scotch moment. There you have it. Just sharing. I won't be doing anything like this again for a while. And to all you Clivey fans, and I know there's a lot of you out there, he's got something like 750,000 subscribers. Thank you for your joining me. If you're at all into whiskey, why not take the opportunity to subscribe to my channel as well as Clivey's channel, because I will kind of counterbalance all his electronic trashing and stuff with my classy monologues on whiskey and other quality spirits. You know? Balances things up for you. Bye.